Earlier today, NASA held a press conference to announce a highly unusual star system known as Trappist-1 that is currently setting the fields of planetary science and exobiology afire. This system doesn't just contain one Earth-like world within its habitable zone, but at least an astonishing three that could conceivably host life as we know it. And they are close, at just under 40 light-years away. The planets were discovered through a method known as transit photometry, initially with the Trappist telescope in Chile and further studied with the Spitzer Space Telescope. Transits occur when planets pass in front of their host star and block just a little bit of its light. In fact, this is how we found out about Boyajian star and many of the known exoplanets. Looking at how much of the light was getting blocked told scientists how big these worlds were, and it turns out that they're small, about the size of Earth. But how much like Earth are they? The key here is the availability of liquid water, like our oceans. You have to be a certain distance from your star in order for water to avoid freezing solid, but also not evaporate into gas. Water is chemistry's universal solvent, the medium where organic reactions can occur. This is key for all life on Earth. Everything needs water to exist. There are a few other ways life might manage to exist, but water-based organic chemistry is by far the best chance. That's where these new planets come in. They seem to not only have the possibility of bearing liquid water like a planet like Proxima B or Earth, but the conditions are such for all three that as far as we know so far, they probably do have water. And there are a further four planets in this system that are also seemingly rocky and are about the same size as Earth. But it's not completely clear yet if they are also within the zone of habitability. In other words, this is a star system that could have seven Earths orbiting it. Now, two of these worlds are probably tidally locked to their star. That puts them in the same league as Proxima B, where they would have a ring of habitability in the twilight zone of the planets. But the sunlit sides would likely be rather hot, and the night side a frozen wasteland, and this could cause extremely high winds, we don't yet know. The third planet is on the edge of the zone of habitability, but is not tidally locked. One thing going against life in the Trappist-1 system is its age. The system is only 500 million years old. This may not be enough time for life to have developed, and it's not anywhere near enough time for intelligent life as we understand it to develop. Another hurdle is the type of star it is. Trappist-1 is another red dwarf, similar to Proxima Centauri and its planet. Recent research suggests that red dwarfs are rather unstable early in life, and this star is bizarrely metal-rich, and it's unclear why that is, or what that means, or what implications that has. So the planets may still be sterile even if there is liquid water present. But this may not be true forever. This star will live an unbelievably long life, at least 4 trillion years. When our sun expands into a red giant and engulfs Earth in just a few billion years, this star will still be young. When most stars of the universe have lived their lives, this star will be among the few main sequence hydrogen-burning stars left in the universe. That leaves plenty of time for life to evolve there at some point in the future. But this system is close enough that it seems likely that if we survive, someday these planets will be colonies. More on that in a minute. The first thing scientists will do is determine if these planets have atmospheres at all and what they are like. This discovery is so important that the Hubble Space Telescope is doing just that already, which will no doubt be the source of future news in the coming months. But a combined spectrum we have for Trappist B and C rules out huge hydrogen envelope atmospheres like our outer planets, and is more consistent with a water vapor atmosphere or a Venus-like atmosphere or even Earth. Where this will get interesting is if you can determine the makeup of an Earth-like planet's atmosphere and you see certain gases within that atmosphere, such as oxygen, it's a dead ringer for the existence of biological activity on that world. If it's there, we could have conclusive proof of life elsewhere in the universe in just a few years, or even sooner. Imagining what it's like in this system is mind-blowing. Because the star is cool and dim, its zone of habitability is far closer to the star's surface than it is with a larger star like the Sun. The first planet would have a year that is only a day and a half long. The second planet's year would just be 2.4 days, and the third is unclear and could be anywhere from 4 to 73 days. The star would appear 10 times larger or more in the sky. You would see planets occasionally pass by that would appear as large as the Moon, and everything would be dim since Trappist-1 is a red dwarf. But it would still be warm on these planets since the star radiates brightly in the infrared. We have always wondered down here on Earth what we would eventually do when our sun expands into a red giant. But the truth of the matter is, our changing sun will make life as we know it on this planet impossible in just a few hundred million years. We arose at the tail end of a 3 billion year process of evolution on a stable planet that simply won't be habitable for much longer. As a result, we must either colonize other worlds or develop future technologies that can mitigate the effects of the changing sun. All is not lost there. I'm confident that there will still be people on Earth billions of years from now. But we do need to branch out, and these seven worlds offer us a place where we could conceivably survive until there's nothing left in the universe to survive on. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently getting ready to launch a second channel. More on that in the near future. And be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channel for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.